Hi and welcome to Vector Garden YouTube channel. I'm Monika and I'm going to show you how to cut lines in Illustrator so that they can be in a shape that you can define like this. So these are just paths that have strokes applied to them. In outline view, it looks like this. These are just simple paths. It's not a clipping mask, which has a couple of advantages when styling these paths. So we're going to start with this file that I have prepared, and there are already some lines and the shape I want them to be in. These lines you can just draw and then press the Alt key, move them, press Command D on Windows, Control D to make copies. So I'm going to delete that. Now, in order to get these lines into a shape, of course, you can create a clipping mask, but then it's not possible to apply the precise rounding of ends to the paths. And of course, in case you want to engrave them or the like, then it won't work as well. So you need to actually cut them. And then of course you can go around and use the scissors tool and cut them all along the shape, but that gets very tedious if you've got a lot of lines and maybe a lot of those shapes. So we need to automate this. And of course, to do that, you need the Pathfinder panel, which is in Windows Pathfinder or down here, and I'm going to put it there. And we need color, so I'm going to take the color panel, which is this one. Move them to the side. Okay, so what we can do to slice these is to just select them, and the Pathfinder we need to use is this one, which is Outline. And what it does is it cuts paths everywhere where they cross. So as you can imagine, we will get a lot of paths. Short ones where this one is cut all along there. So let's see how this will look like. Gonna select them all and press this Pathfinder. Now this is a group, and when I ungroup it, it's gone because Illustrator takes away the stroke color. So I'm going to move them, and there you see all these little parts and pieces, and to clean this up will be a lot of work as well. So I'm going to revert all that like this, and let's see if we can make this a little better. So I'm going to go back into preview mode and let's see how we can improve that. Now, what Illustrator needs for this is a fill color. So I'm going to select all those, and you see they all have just a stroke color. And this one as well. When applying the Outline Pathfinder, Illustrator will apply the fill color of the original path to the result, which is just none in this case. So all of the resulting paths will have a fill of none, which makes it very, very complex to select them. So we will improve that. Now I'm going to select all of these and just fill them black. And this one, I'm going to fill it black first as well, and then let's make it red. So select them all, go to Outline, and then we have this. It's simpler to select now because we have black and red lines, but these are all red as well, so this won't be an easy task as well. So I'm going to revert that, and we will improve it a little more. And I'm going to draw a rectangle around everything. And let's go into outline view, select the shape and this rectangle, and then let's make a compound path. Command and 8 on Windows, Control and 8. And we've got this here. And let's select it all and go to outline. And there we have something that is very, very easy to cut apart, because now I'm going to ungroup it, select one of them, go to select, same, and stroke color. All the red parts are selected. I'm just going to delete them, and there is my shape made out of lines now. And now I can select them all, make the stroke thicker. Let's zoom in here, and you see they are already rounded, but I can apply all these things. You can select here, you can select variable widths and everything I want to have. So that's how you can do that. And the nice thing about this method is that the lines don't need to be straight. It also works with these. You might know that pathfinders are sometimes weird when there are open paths and when there are strokes, and often they just close the paths, which would make this very strange, because when this is closed, it just doesn't work at all. But with this pathfinder, it's very special. It just leaves the paths intact and doesn't close them. It just cuts them. So just what we want to do. So in the case of this one, you can also just draw the rectangle around all of them, select this shape, make the compound path, and then I'm going to fill it and a stroke of none, and just select the lines. I'm going to deselect this shape, and in this case I'm not going to fill them. I'm just leaving a stroke there, which will get deleted. Select all of them, apply the outline pathfinder, and you see they are gone in this case, but they aren't really gone. We're going to outline view, and you see there they are. So we can just ungroup this, select one of them, then go to select, same, stroke color, delete that all, and there we have the nice looking shape. And let's get out of outline mode, apply a stroke color to that, and there we have the pattern. So this is how you can cut strokes with Illustrator. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.